Today we have a joint training exercise with the Marines that are stationed on the Grand Prairie Reserve Complex and the Grand Prairie Police Department SWAT team in the ability to comply with the Defense Department's directive of arming Army Reserve Guard personnel on all Army Reserve complexes across the nation. We want the general public to know that our troops are armed on these posts now, thus making it a little bit harder target. It may make that potential terrorist threat think otherwise coming onto a post. Posturing ourselves in a more aggressive but yet compliant position within the Army Reserve hopefully will reduce, if not maybe possibly eliminate, any acts of terrorism.
If you get in this scenario, I expect you to be aggressive. I don't want to see anybody hide behind doors and walls or any of that kind of stuff. Get it in the mindset you were there to do one thing, that's eliminate the threat. Does that make sense?
Yes.
You're most tracking with that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. All right, let's kick this next one off.
As far as the Grand Prairie facility, I believe we are fully capable of taking care of ourselves if an incident does happen. We know what to do, what to look for. It's not just running around blindly looking for somebody with a gun. We need to look correctly and make sure, okay, that is a gun, they are a threat, that is the shooter. The Grand Prairie PD or SWAT team teaching us this is amazing.
I'm just really grateful to be here. You know, it's a really good experience, really good training. Opportunities like this are kind of few and far between. So being able to come out here and especially coordinate with the people who are eventually going to come and help us out if there's an active shooter situation, you know, the Grand Prairie SWAT team, it's really good for them to be training us because they'll be the ones who come in and ultimately clear the entire situation.
They're starting to learn those team movements and apply those team movements. Understanding angle management, understanding how do I enter a room with a two-person team, how do I enter a room with a four-person team, how do we move through a hallway. What we're really looking for is to create scenario-based training for our soldiers and our Marines. We're just starting to scratch the surface. We're laying the foundation with this two-day training. My expectation is that this unit and any other units that conduct similar training will then take this and build upon it. On a monthly basis, they're going to conduct some training with their guard force so that they're prepared in the event of an active shooter situation.